can I help you? Okay, you have an appointment. What is your name? Let's see. Okay, so I have you scheduled here for a cranial nerve exam, is that correct? Alright, great. Well, my name is Dr. M, and I will be performing your examination today. So if you'd like to go to the restroom and come back and get comfortable, take a seat, we will get started, okay? Okay, so first I'm going to just get some of your basic information and a brief health history for you, and then we will get started with the exam. Sound good? Okay, great. So why exactly are you here for a cranial nerve exam today? I see. So you had a fall and your doctor recommended that you come for a cranial nerve exam. Okay. Have you been feeling since your fall? Okay. So basically the reason your doctor suggested a cranial nerve exam is because we have 12 basic nerves stemming from our brain that help with the sensory and motor functions of the face, neck, head, and shoulders. And they also help with our senses of sight, sound, smell, taste, and touch, as well as some basic movements in the area. So I'm sure you just wanted to make sure that everything was functioning properly. I'll explain a little more about it when we get started, but first, can I get your first and last name, please? Okay, can you spell the last name? Okay. And your middle initial? Okay. Can I get a street address for you? Okay. Mm-hmm. And city, state, and zip? Can I get a primary phone number, please? Okay. And an email address? Okay, great. Can I get your date of birth? Mm-hmm. Okay. And your social security number, please? Mm-hmm. Your place of employment. Great. And your job title. Okay, cool. Can I get a work phone number? Alright. Let's see. Your primary insurance provider. And I'm going to need to see your insurance card as well as your driver's license, by the way. Okay. Okay, great. I'll make copies of this later. Let's see. Can I get a phone number for an emergency contact? Okay. And your relation to the emergency contact? Any allergies? Okay. And are you taking any medications currently? Prescription, over-the-counter, herbal remedies, any illicit drugs? Okay. Do you smoke? Okay. Or use alcohol? Now let's do a brief health history. So when was your last physical examination? Okay. Do you wear glasses or contacts? Okay, and how is your vision with that? Are you wearing them today? Okay. Excuse me if I sound a little stuffed up. I'm actually experiencing some seasonal allergies. Okay, do you wear a hearing aid or have any trouble hearing? Alright, can you generally describe your sense of smell to me? Okay. and taste. Okay, so you did say you had a fall recently. Where did you hit your head? Okay. And how did you fall? Okay. Gotta be careful. Yeah. Okay. Have you recently been experiencing any dizziness? Okay. Headaches? Ringing in the ears? Blurry vision? Difficulty hearing recently? Any tingling in your hands or feet? Okay. Any difficulty swallowing? Difficulty breathing? Have you been feeling unusually hot or cold, like feverish or chilly? Okay. Any nausea or vomiting? Any chest pain? Any stomach pain? Any difficulty with your balance? Or difficulty with speech? Okay, so let's briefly talk about your past health. So have you had any major surgeries? Or minor surgeries? Okay. Have you had any other falls or injuries? In the last, say, 5 years. Okay, I see. Okay, have you experienced in the past any high or low blood pressure? Okay, any diagnosis of mental illness? Okay, any headaches? Any heart problems? Any breathing problems? Gastrointestinal problems, or any difficulty walking or getting around. Okay. And lastly, let's talk about your family's medical history. So in your immediate family, your parents, siblings, grandparents, do you know of any major medical problems any of them may have? Anything else? Okay, I see. Okay, so that should do it. We should be able to get started with the examination now. So, just relax. Before we get started, I am going to briefly explain to you what some of the general functions of the 12 nerves are. So you can kind of understand why we're doing what we're doing. And then after that, we'll get started. And if you have any questions, just be sure to ask, okay? Okay. So we're going to be testing the 12 main cranial nerves today. So cranial nerve number one is the olfactory nerve. It is a sensory nerve, and it helps with your sense of smell. Cranial nerve number two is the optic nerve. It is also a sensory nerve, and it helps with your ability to see far and long distances. Cranial nerve 3 is the oculomotor nerve. Number 4 is the trochlear nerve. And number 6 is the abducens nerve. All of these three nerves help to move your eyeballs in different directions and also to constrict and dilate your pupils. Number 5, which I skipped over, is the trigeminal nerve. This nerve is both a sensory and a motor nerve. As far as sensation goes, it helps you to sense temperature, soft, dull, and sharp sensations in your face. And as far as motor function goes, it helps with your chewing and the control of the muscles in your face. So moving on, cranial nerve number 7 is the facial nerve. It is a sensory and a motor nerve, and as far as sensory goes, it helps with your sense of taste in the front of your tongue. And as far as motor goes, it helps with the symmetry of your facial movements, so raising your eyebrows, smiling, frowning, puffing out your cheeks, things like that. cranial nerve number 8 is a sensory nerve known as the vestibulocochlear nerve, big word. But basically, it helps with your sensation of hearing and also your ability to balance. Cranial nerve number 9 is the glossopharyngeal nerve. This is a sensory and a motor nerve. This helps you taste in the back portion of your tongue for sensations of salty, sweet, sour, and bitter. As far as the motor function, it helps you to swallow. Cranial nerve 10 is the vagus nerve. This actually innervates your entire body, but as far as we're concerned, it helps with swallowing as well, but also with speech and your vocal cord movement. And this is a motor and sensory nerve as well. So as far as sensation goes, it helps with your gag reflex and your ability to feel, you know, if you're choking. Cranial nerve 11 is the spinal accessory nerve. This is a motor nerve that helps with your movement of your neck and your shoulders, and also a little bit in the lower region of your neck. And number 12 is the hypoglossal nerve. And this nerve helps you to move your tongue side to side and up and down. So as far as testing, we're not necessarily going to be moving from 1 to 12. We're going to be kind of grouping them together into related areas, okay? So we are going to start with number 1, which is the olfactory nerve. So for this test, I'm going to have you smell some different scented cubes. And I want you to identify these smells for me, okay? Before we get started, I'm going to put on some gloves. And I'm going to sanitize my hands first. Hand hygiene is very important. Okay, so let's put on these gloves. Wanting to work right today. It's okay. Okay. I pull up my sleeves. And like I said, I'm going to have you smell some different scented cues. So please close your eyes for me, and I'm going to place them one by one under your nose, have you sniff, and tell me what you smell, okay? So here's number 1. What scent was that? Good. Chocolate. Okay. Number 2. Close your eyes. Vanilla. Very good. And lastly, number 3. Take a sniff. What was that one? Yeah, it was strawberry. Very good. Some people can't identify if it's strawberry or cherry for some reason. You did very well in that portion. So next, we're going to check your vision. So I have this homemade eye chart. Pretty accurate. And what I want you to do is close your left eye, or you can cover it. I know it's miniature, but it's fit to size for the distance that we are at. So with your left eye closed, please read the smallest line you can read. Great. Now if you can cover your right eye and do the same, read the smallest line. Very good. And now, with both eyes open. Perfect. Looks like you have 20/20 vision. You did say you're wearing your contacts. It's okay. Alright, so next, we're going to test 3, 4, and 6 together. As I said, this helps with your eye movement. So, for firstly, I'm going to check your pupils. So if you could just stare at my nose, please. Okay. Great. And now I want you to please follow the light with your eyes only. Very good. And now if you could please stare at my pen, and now shift your focus to my nose. Very good. Okay. All right, so next we're gonna test nerve number 5. So for the motor portion, I'm going to have you clench your jaw as if you were chewing or biting down on something, and I'm just going to feel the sides of your face, okay? Need to bite down. Okay, great. So for the sensory portion of this nerve, I'm going to be touching your face in different areas with soft, dull, and sharp objects. And when I do so, I want you to tell me what area of the face I'm touching. Your eyes will be closed. And what sensation you feel. Soft, dull, or sharp. So I have a Q-tip for soft. I have the back of a Sharpie marker for dull. And for sharp, I have a sterile needle. Don't worry, this is not a extremely sharp needle. It is known as actually a blunt needle. But you will note that it is sharp and it won't harm you or penetrate your skin in any way. So. I want you to close your eyes, and I'm going to touch your face in different areas. Like I said, please identify the sensation and the location. Okay. Okay, good. Very good. Yes. Very good. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right. Yes. Mm-hmm. Good. Good. Okay. Very, very good. So we've gotten through the first 6 nerves, and it looks like they're functioning are perfect. So now we will go through the final 6. For this one, I'm kind of going to test nerves 7, 9, 10, and 12 together. These all relate to the tongue. Number 7 does have some facial portions, so we're gonna do that first. This one is for your facial movements. So I'm gonna have you smile for me and frown. Good, can you puff out your cheeks? Good. Raise your eyebrows. Good. And can you turn your head? Just inspect your face. Okay. And the other side. Turn this way. Alright. Very symmetrical face. Very nice. And if you could finally just clench your eyes very tight. Alright, great. So next, we're going to test your sense of taste. So this is for nerves 7 and 7 and 9. So I have a few vials, and these vials contain salty, sweet, sour, and bitter tastes. What I'm going to be doing is withdrawing a little with a syringe and ask you to poke out your tongue. I'm going to put a drop on your tongue and just tell me what you taste, okay? First, please stick out your tongue. Good. That tongue for me? Bitter. Very good. All right. Next. Say ah. Sweet. Very good. And finally. Good. That was sour. Very good job. Okay. So let's see where we are. Okay, next we're going to test the motor portions of nerves 9 and 10 and 12. So for 9, I'm going to ask you to please just swallow a sip of water for me. So here you go. Good. Okay. Okay, please stick out your tongue for me. Good. And say, ah. Great. That was the motor portion of number 10. Now, continue to stick your tongue out for me. I'm just going to touch the back of your throat very lightly and check if your gag reflex is intact. Okay. Sorry, I know that's quite uncomfortable. All right, now we're going to test nerve 12. So please stick out your tongue and press it to the right side against my Q-tip. Okay. And now to the left side against the Q-tip. And can you move your tongue up against the swab? Great. And press down for me. Very, very good. Okay, so I do think that covers the motory and sensory portions of your tongue. So we're going to move back a little bit and go to nerve number 8, which is your sense of hearing and balance. So for balance, all I want you to do is, can you please stand up for me? Good. And can you raise your right leg? Good. And your left. All right. Good job. You can take a seat, and we will test your hearing. So for this portion of the exam, the first part, I'm going to be wiggling my fingers on one side of your ear or the other, and I want you to tell me which ear you hear the movement by, okay? Good. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Good. Uh-huh. Good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Job. Now, I'm going to be coming a little bit closer to you, if that is okay. Okay. And I'm going to be whispering words or phrases side to side in your ears, and I want you to please repeat to me what it is that I've whispered, okay? Alright. Tuesday. Very good. Baseball. Mm-hmm. ASMR. Good job. Yeah. Textbook. Very good. Special. Mhm. Tapestry. Very good. Great job. Your hearing seems like it is perfect. Lastly, to finish up our exam, I'm going to check the motor portion of movement in your shoulders and neck. So I'm going to put my hands on either side of your face, and I want you to resist against the one that I tell you with your head and neck, okay? Alright, so please turn into my right hand. Very good. And my left. Good. Right again. Mm-hmm. And the left. Great. Now I'm going to place my hands on your shoulders. please shrug up against them while I push down. Very, very good. Okay, well, I am so pleased to see that your fall has not affected your sensory or motor function in your head and neck. So I think that you are all clear. Everything looked perfect, really. So, I hope that you're happy to hear that everything looks fine. If you experience any difficulties or problems in any of those areas, please call me, come back in, we'll check you out. And if you have any problems in the future, make sure to come back into the clinic and see me, okay? Alright, well, you have a wonderful day. Okay, bye.